The most common way to get data into Google Analytics is through your tracking code, but you can also add data from other sources. By adding data into Google Analytics, you can give more context to your analysis. There are two ways to add data into your Google Analytics account without using the tracking code: through account linking and through data import. Both are managed via your configuration settings in the admin section of Google Analytics. Any data that you add from these sources will be processed along with all the hits you collect from the tracking code. Let's look at account linking first. You can link various Google products directly to Google Analytics via your account settings. This includes Google AdWords, Google AdSense, and Google Webmaster Tools. When you link a product, data from that product flows into your analytics account. For example, if you link AdWords to Google Analytics, you'll see your AdWords click, impression, and cost data in your analytics reports. In addition to account linking, you can add data to Google Analytics using the data import feature. This might include advertising data, customer data, product data, or any other data. To import data into Google Analytics, there must be a key that exists in both the data that Google Analytics collects and the data you want to import. The key is the common element that connects the two sets of data. There are two ways to import data into Google Analytics: dimension widening and cost data import. With dimension widening, you can import just about any data into Google Analytics. For example, if you're a publisher, you might want to segment your data based on the author and topic of your online articles. While this data is not normally collected by Google Analytics, you might have it stored in an internal system. With dimension widening, you could import author and topic as new dimensions for your content pages. You could use each article's page URL as the key that links the new data to the existing Google Analytics data. Once added, author and topic would be treated just like any other dimensions in Google Analytics. You could add these dimensions to custom reports, dashboards, or segments. You can add data using dimension widening either by uploading a file or by using the Google Analytics APIs. Uploading a file, like a spreadsheet or CSV, is easy, but it can be time-consuming if you need to add data often. To save time, you can build a program that uses the APIs to automatically send data into Google Analytics on a regular basis. The other kind of data import is called cost data import. You use this feature specifically to add data that shows the amount of money you spent on your non-Google advertising. Importing cost data lets Google Analytics calculate the return on investment for your non-Google ads. This is helpful when you want to compare the performance of your advertising campaigns. To import cost data for a specific advertising campaign, you have to have a file that includes both the campaign source and the campaign medium. This information provides the key that can link the two data sources together. Although you'll collect most of your data using the tracking code, account linking and data import are two powerful ways to add more context to your Google Analytics data. By choosing the right data sources to link or import into Google Analytics, you can better measure the performance of your business.